The results.
Yesterday, Parliament voted to remove MP Francis Zake from the position of backbench commissioner after he was found guilty of indiscipline by the Parliamentary Committee of Rules, Privileges and Discipline.
And Honorable Zake ceases to be a member of the Parliamentary Commission.
Addressing journalists at Parliament today, the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, described the process which was used to unseat MP Zake as a mob justice which was staged against the embattled legislator.
All probably were alive to the events of yesterday in the House, in which the House sat and purportedly censured and removed Honorable Zake from the commission to which he was appointed by his party. The events of yesterday, as I did state on the floor, as far as we are concerned, remain a stream of illegalities.
Parliament left at 3 p.m. But normal day, it stopped at 9 p.m. But in normal days where there is essential issues to talk about, we leave at 6 p.m.
Mpuuga pointed out at illegalities which married the process of seizure, citing Rule 110, Section 6, which provides that the commissioner shall be removed upon the vote of at least half of all voting members of parliament.
The jump to amend the resolutions of the committee and the recommendations to include matters not envisaged and without the member being given a hearing rests on critical illegality. But I don't want to really saunter into that arena. I'm very sure when the time comes to officially raise the bar on these issues, they will be able to be laid bare.
Matters of law and rights can never be an excuse for any process. You can never exclude them for any process. We find it very problematic and it's creating a very bad precedent in this country.
One of the recommendations that we are going to make is to ensure that we amend our rules so that we can have a committee, an independent committee, that in case there is any complaint involving the speaker or any chairman of the committee, that independent committee can be the one to hear and preside over the matter.
Mpuuga revealed that they exhausted all avenues of dialogue to protect the only opposition backbench commissioner from impeachment, which was not successful. However, he noted that they are not about to nominate another person for the job.
We did not succeed in getting a settlement to the conflict, because we feared that what started as an altercation would descend into a conflict in Parliament and therefore would serve to curtail the job for which we are elected and for which we are called to serve our people.
Opposition hinted on Zake's next course of action, saying they are going to seek justice in courts of law since Parliament does not have an appeal tribunal.
As the opposition, we are not only obliged, but we are duty bound to stand with our member, whom we think is being unfairly judged, and therefore we shall be by his side through as a six.
The opposition has also given the censure motion mover, Martin Ojaara Mapinduzi, time to explain himself before they can take action against him. Mpuuga wondered the motive of Mapinduzi, a member of the shadow cabinet, to wage a purge against his colleague.
Decency demands that the honorable member is afforded opportunity. I use the word tenability for him as a honorable gentleman to assess the tenability, whether his condition of confusion, if you want me to say it succinctly, is tenable for him to be able to lead a committee charged with a huge duty to deliver the mandate of the opposition in Parliament.
As the opposition slammed Zake's censure process, those who masterminded Zake's impeachment were chest thumping for victory.
He didn't even come to Parliament even yesterday. He didn't even go to the Rules and Privileges Committee to defend himself. To me, he was not interested in the role.
This was not about mob justice. This was about protecting the rules of this House and the integrity of this Parliament.
This story was compiled by Fred Kadiri for the news in Parliament.